Join me as I take on the challenge of breaking down how heat pumps work in just 3 minutes. Heat pumps are an innovative technology that can heat and cool homes efficiently, and today we're going to dive deeper into how they work. Traditional heating and cooling systems have some major drawbacks. They consume a lot of energy, which not only increases our utility bills, but also contributes to climate change. In fact, heating and cooling account for nearly half of the energy used in buildings worldwide. This is a huge environmental impact, and it's clear we need better solutions. Moreover, these systems often require a lot of maintenance, and their efficiency decreases over time. In addition, they can be noisy, and their outdoor units can be an eyesore. It's time to think outside the box and explore alternative solutions that can provide us with a more comfortable and sustainable living space. One of the main reasons we need to rethink our approach to heating and cooling is that our current systems are highly wasteful. In the winter, they try to generate heat by burning fossil fuels or using electricity, which is often generated by burning fossil fuels as well. And in the summer, they work hard to remove heat from our homes, only to release it back into the atmosphere. This is not only inefficient, but also perpetuates our reliance on finite resources. Heat pumps, on the other hand, operate on a fundamentally different principle. They don't generate heat, but rather move it from one place to another. This is a game changer because it means they can provide both heating and cooling while using significantly less energy. So, how do heat pumps work? At their core, they're refrigeration systems that exploit the fact that heat can be transferred from one location to another. They consist of four main components: an evaporator, a compressor, a condenser, and an expansion valve. The refrigeration cycle starts when the liquid refrigerant enters the evaporator, where it absorbs heat from the surrounding air or ground. This causes the liquid to evaporate into a gas, which is then compressed by the compressor, raising its temperature and pressure. The hot gas then enters the condenser, where it releases its heat and condenses back into a liquid. Finally, the expansion valve reduces the pressure of the liquid, allowing it to expand and cool down, and the cycle starts all over again. There are two main types of heat pumps: air source and ground source. Air source heat pumps are the more common type and work by transferring heat between the outdoor air and the indoor air. Ground source heat pumps, on the other hand, transfer heat between the earth and the indoor air. Both types are highly efficient and can provide both heating and cooling. The key insight behind heat pumps is that they can move heat in and out of our homes. This means they can extract heat from the cold winter air and bring it inside, and extract heat from our homes in the summer and release it outside. This process is seamless, and heat pumps can do it all while using significantly less energy than traditional systems. In the winter, they can operate at efficiencies of 300 to 400%, providing 3 to 4 units of energy for every unit of electricity used. And in the summer, they can achieve efficiencies of up to 600%. Heat pumps also have a host of other benefits. They're extremely eco-friendly, producing no emissions or pollution. They're also very versatile, suitable for a wide range of climates and building types. And because they're relatively low maintenance, they can last for up to 20 years or more. In summary, heat pumps offer a highly efficient, eco-friendly, and versatile solution for our heating and cooling needs. They have the potential to revolutionize the way we think about HVAC systems and can play a crucial role in reducing our carbon footprint. Thanks for watching. If you've had any experiences with heat pumps, let us know in the comments below. And if you want to learn more about energy-saving tips, be sure to check out our next video.